So we have polynomial function, and you know that for any polynomial function, domain, it's all real numbers from negative infinity to infinity. Also, we can find y-intercept, and to find y-intercept, we need just to find when x equals zero, then y, or we can say f of zero, it equals zero. Okay, now next step is to find derivative. Then we will construct sign chart and we will find increasing and decreasing intervals. So first let's find what is this derivative. And this derivative equals, could you help me?
X power 3 minus x power 2, 6x power 2.
Very good. So x to the power 3 minus 6 times x 2 power square. Okay. I think it's a good idea here to factor out x square. It's helpful to construct sign chart. And here we have x minus 6. Then I will now sketch sign chart. And here I should plot point x equals 0 and x equals 6. And here will be positive, negative, and positive. So this is sign of derivative. Positive, negative. Oh no, I made here a mistake, or is it true?
No, it's not true, it's negative there too.
Yes, it's negative, from negative infinity, from negative infinity to zero, from negative infinity to zero, it's also negative. Okay. This is sine of f prime x. As for fx, here we have increasing function, here we have decreasing, and also here we have decreasing function. So we can say now that function is decreasing from negative infinity to 6. So from negative infinity to 6, function is decreasing, and from 6 to infinity, positive infinity, function is increasing. Okay, and also we can here identify what is point of extremum. So point of extremum, we have at the critical points. We have here two critical value, x equals 0 and x equals 5. At the point x equals 0, here we have no extremum because function from the left side and from the right side, it's decreasing. And as for critical value, x equals 6, what we have here? Maximum or minimum?
Here we have minimum.
Very good. We have here minimum because from the left side, function is decreasing and increasing. And to find this minimum, we should find point f of 6. And to find f of 6, we should plug in the original equation. So I think it's not a bad idea here to factor out x cube. And in the parentheses, we have 0.25 times x minus 2. Please use your calculator and help me to find what is this value.
I think it's -108.
-108. Okay. So this is minimum. This is minimum function. Okay. So we did successfully two steps. We found domain of function. We found a y-intercept, and we know increasing intervals, decreasing intervals, and we know minimum of function. Minimum of function is -108. Or in other words, we can say that at the point 6, -108, we have minimum. Okay, now next step here is, I will write it here. Next step here then is to find second derivative of function. And second derivative of function, it equals
3x power 2 minus 12x.
Derivative of derivative. And derivative, we have x cubed minus 6 times x squared. Derivative, we have x cubed minus 6 times x squared. And it's going to be 3 times x
squared. 3x squared minus 12x.
Very good. 3x squared minus 12x. Very good. So this is second derivative. Please look very critically. If I have some mistakes, don't hesitate to interrupt me. Now what we need now to construct sign chart. And I think also here is good idea. When we construct sign chart, it's always good idea to factorize expression. And I will here factor out 3 times x. And in the parentheses, we have x minus 4. Now I will construct sign chart for second derivative. And here we have 4 and 0. And here is positive, negative, positive. And here I can write down, this is second derivative of function, sine second derivative of function. And below, under this number line, I will write down here fx. And in this interval, and I will separate these intervals. And in these intervals, what we have here? Derivative is positive. What it means? Second derivative is positive. What it means? It means function is up. Very good, Shota. Function is concave up. Concave up. Here we have concave down.
Yes.
And here also we have concave up. Okay. Now I'm preparing to sketch graph. And for sketching graph, I can plot all important points. I can plot all important points and what I call important points. Important points, when x equals 0, I know correspondence value of function, it's also 0. I can plot when x equals x, when x equals 6, because I know correspondence value. And what value I missed? It's this value. I can't plot this point because I don't know correspondence value of function when x equals 4. And correspondence value of this function, please help me to find it. I should plug it in the original equation. Do you remember this equation? And we here.
It's zero.
Oh, very good. Very good. Thank you, Shota. Indeed, it's zero. So now I will plot in the graph the following points. 0, 0. It's plotted itself because it's origin.
It is not six. Zero, I think.
Sorry, Ratin, say again.
It is not zero, I think.
Oh, is it not zero? Okay, let's check. Let's check. So we should put in the original equation, and this is our original equation. And in this our original equation.
Oh, it's four times. Yeah, he's right.
Oh, thank you very much, Rati. Thank you very much. So it's 4 to the power 3 times 0.25 times 4. It's just 1. 1 minus 2. And 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2, it's negative 1. So it's going to be negative 64. Is it correct now?
Yes, I think so.
Yes. By the way, here is common mistake here. When you are going to find correspondence value of y, common mistake here is when you plug this in the function of derivative or in the function of second derivative. You should remember about that. You should plug in the original function, in the original function. And this is our original function. Okay, so now I know one more point. 4 minus 64. Okay. Now I have everything to sketch this graph. And let me to take photo because I will take photo because I need these results and hopefully you are writing it. Okay, now, next, and next and final step is to sketch graph. But before starting sketching this graph, let me ask if you have any questions.
How about inflection point?
Oh, very good question. Very good question. And inflection point, Rati, we have two inflection points here. Because what is inflection point? Very good. It was a very good question, Rati. Thank you very much. Because I missed it to emphasize about inflection points. We have here two inflection points. This inflection point is 0 when x equals 0 and when x equals 4. Or to be more exact, we have two inflection points with coordinates 0, 0 and 4 minus 64, because here at this point, chart, second derivative, it changed sign. From the left side, here we have concave up, look, concave up, and to the right side, here we have concave down. So we have here two inflection points. And we will now sketch it. Any other question? Nini, do you have any question?
No.
This is most important problem. It's most important problem because it summarizes everything. Okay. If no questions, now let me to start sketching graph. And in this graph, now, I will first of all, I will point our important points. And what are these points? These points are, first of all, origin, 0, 0, its origin. Okay, what is next? Next is 6, negative, here let's here be 6, and 6, negative, let it be
minus
182. Yes, I will now plot point 6, negative 108. 6, negative 108. But take in account that if we make mistake somewhere, it will be impossible to sketch appropriate graph. So these numbers, they must be right. So for example, here we have a negative. Here we have negative 108. Okay. Also, we have point 4 and what was second coordinate? 4 and?
Minus 64.
Okay, 4 minus 64. Let it be here. This is minus 64. Oh, we have this. Okay. So this point and this point, they are inflection points. And we have only one extremo. It at the point, at this point. Okay. Now, okay. Now, I will start now from the infinity, and what I know that this graph is decreasing from, negative infinity to 6. And also I know that at this point, this graph changes concavity. And also I know that from negative infinity to 0, what we have this graph? It's concave up.
Concave up.
So let me start sketching this graph. It's concave up. And from 0 to 4, each concave down. From 4 to 6, it's again decreasing, but this is concave up. And finally, from 6 to positive infinity, it's increasing, and also it's not changed concavity. From 4 to 6, in the interval 4-6, it was concave up, and also it's concave up from 6 to infinity. So to express in more simple form, from 4 to positive infinity, this graph is increasing, this graph is concave up. So this will be our graph. Now look very carefully, look very critically, and ask me any questions if you have it.
You should send the quiz on email, right?
Yes, Nicholas, but this is more important to understand it. If any questions, ask me about it.
No, I understand. It was pretty easy.